Back in 2017, I took a work trip down to Miami, Florida. It was the first time I had ever been to Miami. It was the first time, actually, I ever went to Florida. And man, it's a different world. Growing up in a country where there wasn't a lot of Hispanic people, it definitely was eye-opening, and I loved it. The food, the culture, the buildings, the architecture, the artwork, everything. I just couldn't imagine a place like that existed in the same country as Boston, which is where I live. Just so different. You almost feel like you're stepping into a different country, but it's not. I loved it. I really did. I could definitely see myself living there one day. It's just such a great city. And the shoe I'm reviewing today, it is a collaboration with SoleFly, which is a Miami-based retailer. They've done a bunch of collaborations with Jordan brand before. Last year, they came out with the Jordan 13 SoleFly. I actually think that was a huge sleeper, a very underrated shoe. This shoe today, oh, yeah, I'm excited. I'm super excited, in hand. Beautiful. SoleFly, Air Jordan 8, Mikasa, Esu Casa. Now, this shoe is a tribute to Cuban heritage. Obviously, there's a huge contingent of Cubans in Miami, which honestly gives that city a very cool and distinct and different flavor than anywhere else in the country. And I said again, I enjoy that city very much. I've been there twice now after that first trip. Definitely want to go back again. And Mikasa, Esu Casa, means my home is your home or my house is your house. Now, I had to practice saying that before I made this video. I just cannot pronounce Spanish words for whatever reason, but I'm trying my best. Right off the bat, I'll just say it right now. This is definitely my favorite shoe of the month. Now, this shoe originally dropped on soulfly.com on December 11th, and it is dropping again on sneakers on December 16th for $225. This is one of those shoes, one of those colorways, one of those collabs that I think it's worth the price. I love this shoe. I really do. And this colorway, it is inspired by the colors of the Cuban flag, as well as one of the oldest baseball teams in the old Cuban league. Now, I'm not even gonna try and pronounce it, but the colors are just beautiful. I love the colorway of the shoe. It's honestly one of my favorites of the year. I love red, I love blue, even though I don't love sail when they stick sail on the midsole of shoes that don't need to be sail. The official color actually is sail, metallic gold, as well as fossil. I just really love it. It just looks beautiful together. And this year in 2023, it's also the 30th year anniversary of the Jordan 8. So the Jordan 38 actually has a few references to the Jordan 8. So you'll see the X plate on the 38s. That is a direct reference to the straps that you see on this shoe. And then you'll see 41 cross hatches. That is a reference to Michael Jordan's average during the 1993 NBA Finals. When the Jordan 8 first came out, he was wearing that shoe for his third consecutive championship. And that's also why you see three diamonds on the side of the 38. So a lot of references and tie-ins to this silhouette. Now, the Jordan 8 originally dropped in 1993, designed by legendary designer Tinker Hatfield. It came out for a price of $125 back then. 30 years later, that is equal to about $285 in terms of buying power. Super expensive shoe. Expensive shoe now, expensive shoe back then. And the materials on the shoe, there's a mix of materials. So on the base layer, you see on this side of the shoe, the lateral side of the shoe, there is like a mesh base layer, and that is meant to represent Cuban upholstery. So I really like the little detail there. But on the other side of the shoe, the medial side, you'll see it's more traditional looking mesh, so slightly different setup. And then on the overlays, you have suede. And the suede on the shoe, it's that very dry feeling suede. Personally, it's not my favorite. I really like that really plush and smooth feeling suede. Doesn't mean it's like horrible quality. It's just a personal opinion, personal preference. I don't like that very buffed down and dry feeling suede. And towards the back of the shoe, you'll see in a slightly different color, almost like this beige tan color. That is also suede. You can see the texture of the suede. And that is like that very dry type of suede. And then on the tongue of the shoe, this is pretty standard for a Jordan 8. It is that chenille material. Now, this chenille circle around the Jumpman, it is split up into three different colors, blue, red, and white. So Cuban colors. So on like the Jordan 8 playoffs, the Jumpman, the stitching around it, it is black. So you almost don't see it. You just see the Jumpman. But on this shoe, you'll see this gold and blue stitching. And then the, what do you call it? The clips, I guess, of the straps. That is painted to look like gold. It is plastic, it's not like metal or anything. And that is pretty much expected for a Jordan shoe. But in terms of complementing the colorway of the shoe, just really pops. I love it. And then of course, this being a Jordan 8, you'll have this soft TPU rubber feeling material. And again, just the pattern and the colors chosen, just looks great. And on the straps, there is mismatched branding. So on a general Jordan 8, it'll have 23 on both shoes. On this shoe, however, the right shoe has 23 and the left shoe has SF, standing for SoleFly. And another place you'll see mismatched branding is on the insoles. And speaking of the insoles, that pattern is meant to represent Cuban tiles that you see on a lot of old Cuban homes. You also see that pattern on the paper inside the box, which I'll get to later. I'm a sucker for storytelling, so the more there is, especially for collaborations, the more I like it. And also on the straps, but it's hidden. When you open the straps up, you'll see the name of the shoe, Mikasa, Su Casa. More storytelling, more details, the more I like it. And the Jordan Air does come with a polyurethane midsole with a Nike Air unit on the heel as well as the forefoot. And then one of the coolest outsoles ever, the blue part is made to look kind of distressed, so you see like little spots of white. That's not dust, that's not like a quality issue. That's how it's supposed to look on Nike.com. You can also see that as well. And then this middle cutout, that just looks awesome. Look at the pattern. It just looks awesome. But the honeycomb traction, it's not bad, but overall, if I had to choose one, I'm definitely picking herringbone in terms of performance over the honeycomb. This shoe, unfortunately, doesn't come with any extra laces. For $225, come on. I think they could have afforded at least one extra set of laces, either in the red or the blue, even gold, even white. I think all of that would look pretty good on the shoe, give the shoe a different type of look. So even though I really, really, really like this release, it's my one complaint. And the box of the shoe, just look how beautiful this box is. Just an absolute highlight. Oh, I love this box. It's inspired by a cigar box. Cuban cigars are obviously very, very famous. See SoleFly branding on the side of the box. Mikasa Isukasa on the lid of the box. SoleFly branding again with the Jumpman. Then Miami, Cuba, Fundada, and 1985. I have no idea how you pronounce it, and I just completely winged it, but I'm guessing this means founded in 1985. Love this box. And I'm not done. The paper inside the box, that, just like the insoles, that is a reference to tiles on old Cuban homes. Just love the storytelling. Love the details. Now, in terms of sizing and comfort, even though I have wide feet, I go true to size for Jordan 8s. It does feel pretty snug, pretty tight around my feet, but I have felt if I went up half a size in this shoe, there's too much room lengthwise for me. I don't love it. When I break it in, the Jordan 8s fit pretty well. It also has this neoprene booty that I really like. You see that on the 7s as well as shoes like the Airflight Huaraches. I like that. It actually gives it a more snug feel, but not like tight enough where I feel it's uncomfortable. If you do have wide feet, you can get away with going up half a size if you prefer a more looser feel. For me, I prefer just to loosen up the laces a little bit and then going true to size. Now, one thing I will say, because of these straps, you really do got to take your time to really loosen up the laces when you first break the shoe in, because initially it's hard to get your feet in there. Now, in terms of cushioning, a polyurethane midsole, so it's slightly softer than like a rubber cup sole, and it also has a Nike Air unit both on the heel as well as the forefoot. So it's old tech specs, but tech specs that I enjoy. It's still pretty flat to the ground, which is better for basketball. So if you're into like walking shoes that are super soft, super foamy, old Jordans may not be your best friend. In terms of the padding around the ankle collar, the tongue, inside the shoe, no complaints from me. I think the Jordan 8s are one of the more comfortable Jordans from 1 to 14. Definitely better than the 1s, the 4s, maybe the 3s, pretty similar to the 7s. It's not the most comfortable. I still think the Jordan 5s are the best out of all of them, but Jordan 8s, not far behind. And that brings the total sole score of the Air Jordan 8 SoleFly Mikasa Su Casa to 42 out of 50. A very good score compared to other collaborations. Now, colorway. Yeah, I'm a sucker for this colorway. I don't even love Sail. I feel like they've oversaturated Sail. But in terms of using it with this colorway, yeah, just really, really like it. It's so clean, so very easy to wear. It just really works. And I think the pattern on this part of the shoe, yeah, it's beautiful. In terms of materials, even though I prefer suede that is a bit more plush, a bit more smooth than this shoe, if you're into like the very kind of dry, buff down suede, you'll like this. I do really think it's cool they tied in Cuban upholstery to this side of this shoe. Even though I don't love that material in a vacuum, I think it's a cool idea. There is something about this shoe when you hold it in hand, you feel like you're holding a premium product. It is still cheap plastic, but that's kind of expected. What I do like is this inner booty that you see on 8s, as well as the tech specs of Jordan 8. It's ancient, but it still works. In terms of comfort, like I alluded to earlier, the Jordan 8s are one of the more comfortable shoes for my wide feet. I think it fits pretty well. The snugness may not be for everybody, but even me as a flat wide footer, it still feels very comfortable. The only thing I nitpick about when it comes to the Jordan 8 is during the break-in period. Toe box area can be pretty tight, so definitely have some patience and break the shoe in. In terms of the versatility, I think the Jordan 8s are obviously a very out there and different and retro kind of shoe. But I always say this, this is one of those shoes where on feet and hand, it looks better than if you imagine yourself wearing the shoe from images. It just is. In terms of the colorway, it's very muted and it's got some standard colors like red and blue. The colors on the shoe makes it very easy to wear. The gold isn't like super loud where you're like, why did they have to put such a bright shiny gold on the shoe? It's kind of muted, kind of dampened, so I think it just fits them perfectly. I think this shoe, pretty versatile. In terms of storytelling, I'm a sucker for storytelling, and when it comes to collaborations, I think storytelling is an important metric. Otherwise, why not just make a general release? Why collaborate at all? And the details, the subtle little details on the shoe, I really enjoy. That's the most fun about doing this whole thing. When you research a shoe that has like a story behind it, you find little nuggets. Like when you first see the shoe and you see this pattern on the panel, you might not tie it back to Cuban upholstery, but there it is. And the Cuban tile pattern that you see on the insoles, as well as the paper inside the box. And the box itself, that's probably like the highlight in terms of storytelling. I'm a sucker for all of it. They really did a good job of storytelling on the shoe. Now I've reviewed 3 Jordan 8s this year, and I think it's been a pretty good year for the Jordan 8 silhouette. It's hard to beat the Jordan 8 playoffs. It's an OG colorway, but this is about as close as you can get. It's beautiful. It's wearable. The storytelling is on point. I love it. So that's it. Thanks for watching Sole Inclined. Let me know what you think of the SoleFly Air Jordan 8 Mikasa Esu Casa. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.